We know what the cruise ship industry brings to Greater Victoria every year. Hundreds of thousands of tourists and millions of dollars. But there is a new spotlight tonight on the sheer amount of garbage those giant vessels leave behind. CTV's Sarah Reed has more.
Well, instead of the city of gardens, I feel like it's the city of garbage.
This is the view from Linda Klein's building on Dallas Road. Piles of garbage, compost, and recycling, all of it coming off cruise ships.
I feel that most of the people in Victoria have no idea that we are taking all of the garbage from every cruise ship that comes in here.
The facility outside Klein's window belongs to waste management service Tymac, which has been handling cruise ship waste in the CRD for 2 years.
We take everything off our trucks and we consolidate it into the mainstream. So the paper will go to the paper bin, plastic into plastic bin, and then we take each of those bins to the appropriate recycling facility for final treatment.
But the new facility at Ogden Point is bringing new attention to the sheer amount of garbage coming off the ships.
They're huge transport trucks. They're not little trucks, they're big trucks.
Tymac says 90% of what it receives is recyclable, but the other 10% is what's causing concern. In the case of handling garbage, bigger cities are just better prepared.
So there's a lot of opportunity, especially in Vancouver. They have an incineration plant, so a lot of the stuff we can send to waste energy.
But on the island, what can't be reused ends up at Heartland Landfill in Saanich, which is 150 tons a month during the season.
Victoria's a little limited in what they have resource-wise.
With no way to dispose of waste, some people are wondering why it's being accepted.
Everybody's talking about being green. Is it green to take that type of garbage? I don't feel it is.
Tymac says Victoria has better programs than other ports, but wants more to be done. The CRD says it's open to the idea of a waste energy facility.
It's sad. It's sad.
But until that happens, Klein says this view will serve as a reminder of the impact waste has on our world. Sarah Reed, CTV News, Victoria.
The cruise ship industry is also facing criticism from a Canadian conservation group. World Wildlife Fund says the massive boats are responsible for dumping the vast majority of potentially toxic gray water. That includes drainage from dishwashers, sinks, and showers. It can carry contaminants like oil, disinfectants, and fecal coliform. The group finds ships traveling between Washington State and Alaska account for 1.37 billion of the roughly 1.5 billion liters of gray water generated off the BC coast in 2017.